Dear students, in this class we are going to discuss about the electron transport system. The electron transport system is nothing but the final point in the all the catabolic reactions which is going to take place inside the cells. So here catabolic reactions of the all the different biomolecules are going to be involved in the providing the energy to the cells. How these catabolic reactions are going to provide the energy to the cells? So here if you look at the all these processes in brief, so here the fats such as the phospholipids and also the triacylglycerols will be converted into the fatty acids, and these fatty acids will be converted into the acetyl-CoA will be entered into the Krebs cycle. Whereas the carbohydrates also will be converted into the simple sugars. These simple sugars will be converted into the pyruvate and will be converted into the acetyl-CoA, and this one also will be enters into the Krebs cycles. Whereas the proteins, they will be digested into the simple amino acids. These simple amino acids are also in one or the other way, they are going to be enters into the Krebs cycles, and ultimately they are going to provide the energy to the cells. But here, how exactly all these catabolic reactions are going to provide the energy to the cells? So here, in all these catabolic reactions of the different biomolecules, very importantly we need to remember is, so here the molecules such as the NAD and the FAD, so here they are going to be converted into the NADH and also the FADH2 in all these different catabolic reactions. So here, in other words, this NAD and the FAD, they are going to capture the electrons from the catabolic reactions, and they are going to reduce into the NADH and also the FADH2. So here, in the simple way, so here these molecules, they are going to extract the energy from the catabolic reactions in the form of the electron, and here they are going to get reduces into the NADH and also the FADH2. So here these two reducing equivalents, so here ultimately after capturing the electrons from the catabolic reactions, so here they are going to donate the electrons to the electron transport system, which is going to take place in the mitochondria. So here these electrons will be donated from the NADH and also the FADH2 to the electron transport system, and here due to which the electron transport chain operates, and it is going to result into the series of electron transfer reactions. So here the series of electron transfer reactions which is going to take place in the electron transport system, and due to which ultimately the ATP will be generated in the mitochondria. So here that is how catabolic reactions of the all the different biomolecules will be ultimately result into the production of the ATP inside the cells, and here that is the reason why the mitochondria, it is called as the powerhouse of the cells. So here, before understanding the electron transport chain in detail, we need to understand the structure of the mitochondria briefly first of all. So here the mitochondria which is having the two membranes, so here the outer one which is called as the outer membrane, whereas the inner one obviously it is called as the inner membrane. So here the outer membrane, it will be having the small pores, they are called as the porin channels. So here the outer membrane which is having the small pores, it is called as the porin channel. So here through the porin channels, so here the molecules below the size of the 5000 Daltons, they are going to enter into the mitochondria. Whereas the inner membrane, so here it will be having the specific transporter. So here if the any molecule which is having the transporter in the inner membrane, so here then only it can cross the inner membrane. So here this inner membrane, it will be having the many involutions, and here these involutions are called as the cristae. And here the inside the mitochondria, so here it is called as the matrix. And here what is the role of the mitochondria, and that we need to remember. So here the mitochondria which is having the enzymes for the Krebs cycle, and also the amino acid oxidation enzymes also will be present, fatty acid oxidation enzymes also will be present, and apart from that one, the enzyme complex called as the pyruvate dehydrogenase complex also will be present in the mitochondria. And very importantly, apart from all these things, so here the components of the electron transport chain, they are also present in the mitochondria. So here very importantly, so here in the inner mitochondrial membrane, so here it is the inner mitochondrial membrane, so here on this inner mitochondrial membrane, all the components of the electron transport chain will be present over there. So here in a simple words, so here the inner mitochondrial membrane, it is the site of the electron transport chain. So here, in between the inner membrane and also the outer membrane, a space is there. It is called as the intermembrane space. So here, now we understood that. So very importantly, so here the electron transport chain, which is going to takes place on the inner mitochondrial membrane. It is the site of the electron transport chain, which is going to takes place. And apart from that one, the mitochondria also it will be hanged its own genetic material, and also it will be hanged the ribosomes also. Some of the enzymes of the mitochondria will be synthesized by the genetic material of the mitochondria itself. So here up to this we discuss about the structure of the mitochondria. And now we need to discuss about the components of the electron transport chain. So here what are all the enzyme complexes which are present in the electron transport chain, then we need to understand in detail. So here the electron transport chain, it will be having the four complexes, and they are generally called as the complex 1, complex 2, complex 3 and the complex 4. So here all these four complexes, they will be having the specific names to it. Whereas the complex 1, it is called as the NADH dehydrogenase. Its size is around 850 kilodalton, and the number of subunit which is present in it is nothing but the 43 daltons. In case of the bacteria, it will be having the 14 subunit. And apart from that one, some of the prosthetic groups which are present in these complexes. So here the complex 1, it will be having the FMN and the iron sulfur centers as the prosthetic groups. These prosthetic groups, they plays a very important role in the electron transfer reactions. So here, whereas the complex 2, it is called as the succinate dehydrogenase complex. So here it is one of the Krebs cycle enzyme, which is going to be involved in the conversion of this succinate into the fumarate. So here the complex 2, it is called as the succinate dehydrogenase. Its size is around 140 kilodaltons. It will be hanged with the 4 subunit. The prosthetic groups which is present in it is nothing but the FAD and also the iron sulfur centers. Whereas the complex 3, it is called as the ubiquinone cytochrome C oxidoreductase. Its size is around 250 kilodaltons. It is having the 11 subunits. And here the prosthetic groups which are present in the complex 3 is nothing but the hemes and also the iron sulfur centers. Whereas the complex 4, it is called as the cytochrome oxidase. So here its size is around 160 kilodaltons. It is having the 13 subunits. In case of the microorganisms, it is having around the 3 to 4 subunits. It will be having the hemes and the two copper atoms as the prosthetic groups. So here we will be having the one more protein component. It is called as the cytochrome C. So here this cytochrome C, its size is around 13 kilodaltons, and it is having the only made up of only one subunit, and it will be having the heme as the prosthetic groups. And here this cytochrome C, it is one of the important component of the electron transport system. It is called as the, it is act as the mobile electron carrier. It is going to transfer the electrons from the one complex to the other complex. Apart from that one, there is one more component is there. It is called as the ATP synthase complex. It is sometimes it is called as the fifth complex. Okay, so here the this ATP synthase complex, it is actually responsible for the ATP generation or the production in the electron transport system. So here collectively all these complexes make the components of the electron transport chain. So here very importantly, basically the electron transport chain, it will be having the four complexes. So here we need to remember the names of those four complexes very importantly. So here the complex 1, it is called as the NADH dehydrogenase, whereas the complex 2, it is called as the succinate dehydrogenase, whereas the complex 3, which is called as the ubiquinone cytochrome C oxidoreductase, whereas the fourth complex, it is also called as the cytochrome oxidase. And sometimes ATP synthase complex, it is also called as the complex 5. So here that you need to remember. And apart from that one, we need to remember the different prosthetic groups which is present in the all these complexes, because all these prosthetic groups, they play a very important role in the transfer of the electrons. So here in the next class, we are going to discuss about all these electron carriers and their features. Okay, thank you.